Hi Pisces, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I am here to do your reading for the first week of May. Now, this could resonate at any time, but it is for the first week of May. April 30th through May 6th, this is for the sign of Pisces. Generally, my readings are love readings. We will see whatever comes up. Somebody could be in denial or starting to let go of sorrow, hurt, starting to heal. Queen of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. There's been some sort of betrayal here with the Seven of Swords. Lies. Could be even cheating. Deception. Sneaky behavior. Taurus again. The Empress reversed is smothering. Maybe you dealt with a person that was smothering. Or you've been dealing with somebody who's smothering. Okay. There's something to do with somebody who is overly motherly. Okay. There's a lack of growth here. But probably with this person, whoever this Queen of Pentacles is, there's a lack of growth. There's been some sort of deception, lies. There's no longer anything solid. There's nothing solid. There's no new beginning here. So perhaps you've decided to, you know, get on the mend. Okay, get on the mend. There's absolutely no new beginning here with this person. There's been too much. Too much has happened. And you know, it feels like there's been some extremes here. There's been a lack of balance and there's been a lack of harmony. And there's things have been like up and down and up and down. Like a roller coaster. All right? Yeah, there's no victory in success. There's no victory in success. There's a lack of confidence in this person. You're dealing with a person that is smothering, could be selfish. They're very stubborn, hard-headed, a very hard worker, very secure and stable in their own right, but there's no beginning with you. There's no solid, there's nothing solid here for you. It's like it's being thrown away. It's like the solid beginning, the solid start is being tossed away. There's a lack of victory and success because of some sort of betrayal or sneaky behavior. And somebody is being called to do the right thing. This is a card of integrity, finding your backbone. This could even signify an apology. Even though, you know, it's not an easy thing to do, somebody has to find their moral backbone to do the right thing, to move forward, to take charge. Because right now there's a lack of balance and harmony in a relationship. Could be with this person. Because there's been some sort of lies and sneakiness, and somebody needs to find their backbone. and act with integrity. This is forgiveness is needed as well. This card. So maybe there's some forgiveness that is needed. I think we had forgiveness in your last one. Nine of Pentacles. This can signify Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. I think you guys are dealing with an earth sign. This is Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn as well. So you got a lot of earth here. Okay. This right here is not enjoying life right now, not feeling abundant, not feeling secure, not feeling stable, not feeling prosperous, losing, not feeling grateful, not happy about life at this time. You know, you have a decision to make. You have two paths and you have to make a decision. You have options. Somebody may have thought the grass was greener on the other side, but it really wasn't. I need to make sure this is zoomed in. So this is for the week, the first week of May. So this is the outcome. It's time to make a decision. I feel like there's a lot of restlessness and you need to decide. Do you go after this person and apologize or not? You have an opportunity right here. This is about cooperation. This is about partnerships. But it's about either do I do it or do I not do it? You're at a crossroads. Do I or don't I? Do I or don't I? And here we have the same thing. Things are out of balance. Like a roller coaster, ups and downs, up and downs. Either way, whatever's going on, somebody isn't enjoying life. Not feeling successful and victorious because of some sort of lies and deception. You need to follow your heart with that Empress reverse. Somebody isn't following their heart. Oh, they're definitely not following their heart. Thank you, Lord. Emotionally unavailable. A lack of dream coming true. There's a lack of emotion here. And it feels like you are just literally unable to show your emotion to this person and have a new beginning. Maybe there's no more love. But there's a struggle here. Somebody needs to look at something from a new perspective. The Hangman is stalling, holding on for no reason. Being enlightened, though, so maybe it is for good reason, this stalling, learning something while he's hanging there. Just hanging. I'm just hanging. Hanging myself. Waiting. What are you waiting for? What are you waiting for, Pisces? This is the master of non-attachment. You are being called to struggle through something, look at something from a new perspective, and stand up and take a risk. You're stuck. You're stuck on the roller coaster. It's not stopping. It's going round and round and round and round. And it's made you emotionally unavailable. Somebody could be in denial and forgiveness is needed so that they could have a new beginning. But they don't want to apologize, but they're being called to apologize or to do the right thing because this is what this card is. And you better get moving. And I don't want to repeat last week's reading, but the cards say what they say. If this is the message the universe wants to give you, then, and it comes through me, then so be it. somebody needs to get on their horse and put it, kick it in the ass and get moving. Or on the sides. I don't know. I never rode a horse. But that horse is moving. Somebody needs to get moving. Can you see it? Somebody needs to charge in and take charge. Go after what they want. Post haste. Or they're gonna lose. The Ace of Cups. That's the Ace of Cups. The love is going to disappear. It's going to be gone. The opportunity will be lost, Pisces, if you continue to be emotionally unavailable and not forgive. True love is the Ace of Cups. Will be lost. It's reversed. It will be thrown away like this. Somebody needs to come out of this darkness and see the light. Oh, I think in the other one, we had this one right next to this one. I can't remember, I can't remember exactly what the whole reading said, but this is fast, move fast, very fast movement. This one is to communicate quickly. Quick communication is needed if you don't want to lose. Stubbornness and hanging on to something, hanging on to your stance, isn't getting you nowhere. It's causing you a big loss. Whew. Okay, what message do you have for Pisces this week? What does Pisces need to know? What advice does Pisces need? I think I told you. That's what I just heard. You already told them. Son of a gun. This isn't a game. It's not a game. It's time for somebody to come off. Come out. I feel like you guys have been restraining yourself from communicating. You've been trying to focus on your inner being. You've become self-aware. You've taken that time of reflection to figure out what you want. But now it's really time with this Five of Wands to end this tension and conflict. There is potential for a commitment and contentment. This is the commitment card. If someone would get moving. You know who I'm talking about, Pisces. You do. And somebody has to get moving towards the one that they love. Move on. Get moving. It's a time of transition. Right now, there's so much lack of balance and harmony and organization in your life that you could be going through some sort of financial mess. Because you're on a roller coaster, an emotional roller coaster. So when you're on an emotional roller coaster, it affects every other facet of your life. So it feels like somebody has to get moving, like I said. it's time to let go of your stance with the hanged man. Stop hanging around doing nothing about it. Do something about it. And somebody that is watching this, that is a Pisces, is resisting their true feelings. But you're being called to struggle through it and do the right thing. Do follow your heart, Pisces. Offer love. This is an offer of love. Follow your dreams. There you are. Sitting back and watching. Observing does no good if you don't take action. You may find it difficult to communicate, but it could lead to something exciting. Try to stay focused. I think that you are dealing with something that was started a long time ago, because this is something that has started a long time ago. You know what this is. You've been very confused about it. And you've probably been angry and bitter and upset and probably watching whoever this person is that I'm talking about. You know who this person is. But you have been letting your fear and your illusions and your confusion hold you back. I think there's some secrets here inside of you that you are so afraid to let out. You could be receiving an invitation to some sort of gathering where you run into this person. Don't let fear hold you back from happiness. Woo! Two kings. I think we had kings in the last one. Is there two men, other men in the picture? Because these are men. We have a fire sign and an earth sign. Somebody's not trying hard enough. Somebody's not putting in any effort. And it's mirroring you. This is you. The moon cutter is represented by Pisces. You have competition, Pisces. This is competition. This is. The Five of Wands is competition. Pisces has competition. A fire sign and an earth sign. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Pisces isn't putting any work. They may be observing whoever this person is, but they're not willing to do the right thing, find their backbone, and communicate, because communication is needed. And that Four of Cups is they're going to lose. And I know this is repetition from before, but energies, they don't just end like that. They don't. If you guys don't make the changes, then it's going to keep repeating. What you resist persists. Have you ever heard that saying? What you resist persists. You can't fight destiny. And I don't have the Wheel of Fortune here to tell you that. I don't need it. You guys, and the Hangman is about resisting. And then you could look it up if you wanted. And that is mirroring you as well, because it was right here. So this is you, mirroring you. You have been resisting doing what you have to do. Not putting in effort, not putting in work, not trying hard enough, keeping secrets, leaving yourself in illusion and confusion, letting fear hold you back, fear of rejection, all the while observing whoever this person is from afar, Could be on social media, I don't know. And you do have competition. That is the truth. There's a lack of wish fulfillment, and someone is going to walk away and not look back. This is going to end with a whole lot of disappointment. So I'm going to have to keep telling you guys, until you find your moral backbone, this message will continue to be similar until you get off the branch. Until you stop resisting. If you guys don't stop resisting, your true heart's desires, we're going to keep getting the same message. That's the way it goes. Not answering the call. Not refusing to wake up. Refusing to accept the truth. Refusing to forgive. This is a forgiveness card. It's reversed. Forgiveness is needed big time. And we had forgiveness before in the other reading. I know we did. It's almost to the point of no return. And it's going to end with a whole lot of emotional disappointment. There's going to be a lack of wish fulfillment, a lack of happiness, and complete loss. I don't like to give the same message, but I can't. Only people that can change the energy is you, you know? The reader can't change the energy. You guys can. You guys have to take action. And you're not. And if you don't, then the reading doesn't change. Somebody is hanging around, letting their fears, letting their confusion rule them. And they're feeling a whole lot of unhappiness, disharmony, unbalance, mental turmoil. Emotional detachment because of it. When all they have to do is get on their horse and give it a kick in the ass, I suppose. I don't know what you do with horses. And get moving. Whoo! Change. Change. What more can I say? Instead of sitting there thinking about it, do something about it. Somebody's not accepting the truth. In many decks, this card is labeled truth. It's reversed. Refusing. If you want these readings to change, you're going to have to do something about it. Make yourself emotionally available. Follow your heart. Until you do, what you resist persists. Hopefully next week this is different. I wish you the best. Hopefully you guys communicate before it's too late. Because the clock's a-ticking.